but I think it must have been fortune and fame. Shot down in flames. Isn't it strange how fortunes can change? One slip away.
Take five.
I don't get it. How come Leisha doesn't dig me? I never failed with any woman before. I think you just lack self-confidence.
Ah, oh, that sounded great, Marty. The band is really gonna add zip to our anniversary party. Something wrong?
I was just thinking. You and Frank, 25 years. Your marriage is older than I am.
How nice of you to point it out.
Louise, I was just wondering, do you and Frank still, you know, do you still,
Well, sure, we... The important thing, Marty, is that Frank and I are very, very close. We are equal partners.
Well, that's what I thought.
Hey, Goldilocks. I'm free this weekend. Luckiest break of your life.
Why, are you leaving town?
Huh? Oh, did I say this weekend? I'm sorry to get your hopes up. I'm busy this weekend, completely booked.
Well, I'm glad you're on top of your schedule.
You know why I can't get through to her?
She puts up barriers, Philly.
Man, you're the barrier. Why don't you ask her out like a person? Hey, Goldilocks?
Oh, what am I asking you for? When was the last time you took the train to Loveland?
Hey, I take the train sometimes. I may not be a commuter like you. I take the train now.
Louise, how did you know that you could commit to Frank? I mean, relationships fascinate me, and I wanted to know. I mean, I know that I'm not ready to commit to anyone.
Well, Martha, it's easy when you have someone as sharing and caring as Frank. I made a promise to love and honor...
And obey. Don't forget obey. That's the beauty part, boys.
Back then, we said obey, but I'm sure if we got married today, we'd say cherish just like everybody else.
That's why marriages today don't last. You know, love is a nice thought, but obey. That's the glue, obey. You know, I don't know where this honor stuff come in.
Sharing and caring.
Oh, I'm sure Frankie's just showing off for the boys, I hope.
You know, this brings us back to the problem you're having with that little blonde cupcake. You know, let me explain this now. Women need direction in their life. And you know what direction that is? Your way.
See, Phil, you should be writing songs about this instead of all that love stuff.
Frank, I don't obey you.
Louise, not now. I'm giving my nephew a couple of tips.
Frank, if anyone needs direction, you do. If I weren't around, you'd miss half your belt loops. And that's just for starters.
You'll have to excuse my wife. She's showing off a little bit. Louise, both you and I know you're totally dependent upon me. It's the natural order.
Yeah.
You know, not to be ashamed of.
Frank, maybe we should take this opportunity to think about our relationship. Maybe it'll be healthy if we spend a few days apart.
Louise, what are you suggesting? You'd be miserable. I won't be there. Where would you stay? Where would you go?
I'll stay at once.
No way, woman. You have responsibilities here in the club.
I can fill in.
Louise, you got a job here at the club to do.
No, Frank.
I didn't quite hear that first word.
It was no. At least that's what I heard.
Marriage is a two-way street, Frank. You can reach me at Mom's. I'll be there for the next 2 days.
I can't get it. I'm having trouble with this song for Frank and Louise. I refuse to rhyme love with above. Maybe with glove. Works for Michael Jackson.
You know why I can't get through to Leisha? Because she's rich. She comes from a whole different world, and I come from the other side of the tracks, Philly.
Gino, that's the heart of your appeal. Why don't you just ask her out like a regular person, Have a nice dinner for two. Tell her how you really feel.
Be honest with her? Oh, come on. That trick never works.
Oh, yeah. And your proven methods have been working so well with Lisa.
Honesty, huh?
Kind of crazy. It's a little wild. You're a little chancy. But I'll try it. I'll try being honest with her.
I'm telling you. The mid-80s, an age of romance.
Who is it?
Hi, guys. Listen, I'm sorry to bug you, but think I could watch your television tonight? Mine's broke.
Borrow the TV at the club, Frank.
Oh, I forgot about that one. But listen, as long as I'm here, do you mind if I crash on your couch tonight?
Well, we won't. The sofa might.
Nah, I don't think the sofa will mind. For a night.
Oh, okay, great. Great. Hey, look. There's a Kojak festival on TV from dusk to dawn.
Hey,
look at the way he's telling that broad off. Boy, he's a master. Wow.
Frank, did you write this poem? I hear the ticking of the clock. Alone. How do I get you alone? Frank, there's some great stuff in this.
That's mush. I did that as a joke. Hey, watch this episode. He's gonna crack a drug ring.
Frank, Kojak cracked a drug ring every week.
Yeah, but they were different drugs.
I hope this anniversary party comes off.
Well, that kind of depends on if the marriage goes on. You know, I wish you hadn't asked Louise all those questions. She hasn't set foot in the bar since.
You know, I don't feel guilty enough. I was wondering if you could help me with that.
I need to talk to Lisa.
Real smooth, Gino. What's up, Gino?
Well, actually, my Sherry Amore, I was thinking that we'd go somewhere a little more quiet. Maybe you'd like to go to dinner with me. I made reservations at Le Habitat restaurant.
Oh, what a fabulous restaurant. I didn't know you liked Nouvelle cuisine, Gino.
Oh, me and Nouvelle go way back. Are you kidding? You know something? There are a lot of things that you don't know about me, Lisa. Like, for instance, I happen to be a very caring person.
Yeah.
Very honest person. I know a smattering of French.
I'd love to have dinner.
Oh, bingo. Okay, this is great. Thursday night, all right?
Oh, no. I'm sorry, I can't go on Thursday.
Why?
I have a date.
Oh, I get it. You get around. Fine, I know your type. But listen, I can get a date, okay? The kid can get a date.
I'm sure the kid can.
Yes, I can. I'm a moving on kind of guy. I'm like the breeze.
Gino, your acting is ridiculous as a prank.
I take that as a compliment.
This is an outrage. I know I am the 17th caller. I'm sure of it. You give me that toaster oven.
There's an order up for table 5. Get off the blower.
Okay, this time, but only because you are much larger than I am.
Hi, Frank, I'm back.
Yeah. I don't see why. Everything's going great here. It turned out to be a great worker. Morris, I think there's an order up to table 5, huh?
Weiner.
Frank, could we talk? I came to tell you that I'm ready to come back. I'm willing to admit that I missed you. Well, didn't you learn something, too?
You know, this is very interesting. This entire affair has turned out to be the exact opposite of what you thought it should be, hasn't it? You wanted to leave me. Now you want to come back. You know, that's a real chuckle. You expected to walk in here and find me pining away for you. In fact, I'm having a ball. I'm having a ball out here finding out what it's like living on my own. In fact, I'm lapping it up.
All right. Maybe what you want is a real separation.
See, Gino? Never let him...
No, it's better I find out now what kind of man Frank is. Boy, have I been blind for 25 years?
Louise, you are happy. I mean, happiness is something you know by feeling, not by thinking about it.
Well, I don't feel happy now. And I thought about it, and I shouldn't have been happy then. Well, maybe it's just something you shouldn't think about.
I'm seeing something in Frank I never knew was there. He hurt me.
Louise, don't you know that Frank hurts too? He really loves you.
Yeah, well, he's got a funny way of showing it.
He's not showing it. He's hiding it.
Oh, he's hiding it? After 25 years, he's hiding things from me? What kind of relationship is that?
Okay, Louise. Sure. He's acting like a jerk. A big jerk.
Hi, guys. I hope I didn't wake you up. Listen, I had your key duped. Listen. Being at Kojak Week is over, I got everything all set up. I got reservations at the Capri Bowling Lanes for tomorrow night. Later on, we'll go to the golf link and we'll soak up a few suds before we
Frank,
go.
Frank, you can't stay here anymore.
Hey, guys, I'm not Cross.
Frank, you remind me a lot of a friend of yours. I am talking about Kojak.
You know where you're going with this?
Frank, you both got police backgrounds. Both stared down the gun barrel of danger.
Of course, you could do a lot more with your hair than he can, but...
And, Frank, both you and Kojak are going to be going home to... lonely, dark, empty apartments.
Hey, that's the freight you pay for being tough.
Frank, Being tough does not just mean being a hard guy.
That's right, Frank. Sometimes you gotta be tough on yourself. You gotta face the way you feel, Frank. Face it. You need Louise. She needs you.
Hey, guys, stop pushing me around. I know the way I feel.
Why don't you feel honest about something for once, huh? Why don't you just be honest? Be honest to Louise.
Okay, I'll sleep on it.
Somewhere else, Frank.
Good night.
That was good. Real good. You ever hear the phrase, physician, heal thyself? Talk to Lisa Gino. Be honest this time.
You know what happens to guys that are right too much of the time? Sometimes they get their head pinched off.
That's good. Good honesty. I like it. Keep it. Use it.
One more step, Charlie, and you're going to be catching lead.
You wouldn't really shoot me, would you, Frank?
Louise! What are you doing here?
Oh, I just came to pick up some things.
Oh. Oh. Yeah, take your things. They're cluttering up the place and they're cramping my style.
What happened to you, Frank? You don't act like yourself anymore.
Maybe you never really knew me. Maybe I got soft living with you. But I found myself. Now, if you want to come back to me, you're going to have to take me the way I am.
I don't want you the way you are now.
Take it or leave it. Louise, thank God you didn't go.
forgot my purse. Wait, I thought you wanted me to leave.
No, I didn't.
Frank, you're not making any sense.
Louise, my life makes no sense without you.
Oh, Frank, in our 25 years together, you never said that.
Well, I'm going to say something else, too. Remember those marriage vows we took? Well, don't tell anybody. But you can change, obey, to cherish.
Frank, do you realize what you're saying?
Louise, in our 25 years of marriage, I've never been away from you. That first night, when I was there, alone, and I said to myself, she's not here. What would I do if I really lost her? What would I do then? Louise, I need you. I know that now more than ever.
I got a confession. I didn't come here to pick up my things. I came here for you.
Well, thank God I was here.
Frankie. So, spending some time apart was good, huh?
No. It was terrible. It was awful. It was downright bad.
Well, let's get it over with.
Yeah, all right.
Oh, Frank.
Let's go home.
You're making this very difficult for me.
It wouldn't be so difficult if you talked to me like a normal person.
All right, you want a normal person? I care about you, Lisa. This normal guy cares about you. How was that? It was? Why was it so wonderful?
Because it wasn't an act.
Oh. I thought maybe you thought it was wonderful because you feel the same way I feel about you.
Gino, give this thing time. I really like you. But I'm still trying to figure out my life and my career and everything. I'm just not ready. But don't give up hope.
Well, maybe someday in the mid-80s?
Maybe someday in the 80s.
Thank you. And now for that spotlight dance featuring our happy couple. Frank, Louise, we're going to play your song.
I don't have a song.
Oh, you do now. And it's in honor of you, Louise. And Frank wrote most of the lyrics.
I did?
Yeah, I got them from this little poem you wrote to Louise.
Those were just some thoughts I jotted down.
Come on out here, you crazy kids.
I'm lying here in this picture.
know how long I have waited, and I was gonna tell you tonight. But the secret is still my own, and my love for you is still unknown.
More dreams come true at 5:15 next Thursday.